farm workers in Delano, California, have begun an unprecedented strike in the Central Valley.
We believe the United Farm Workers and their leader, Cesar Chavez, represent the hope and aspirations of the vast majority of farm workers.
Every American has a stake to bring about social change within the system.
So who the hell is this Cesar Chavez?
Yeah, I heard he's Mexican.
Seems a safe bet.
I'm angry that I live in a world where a man who picks your food can't feed his family.
We don't need you. We want you back to Mexico. Get the hell out of our country.
What do you think you're looking at, huh?
The citizens of Delano, they respect the law.
So do we, especially the Bill of Rights.
Have you seen the headlines they're getting? That's costing us real money, Mr. Bogdanovich.
We don't have to negotiate. We have to dictate terms.
Last report estimates that we've cost them $17 million.
We can't hold on much longer. We're gonna break this damn strike.
You can't oppress someone who's not afraid anymore.
Diego, how you doing, brother?
I am very good.
Good to see you again, man.
Thank you.
You know, I love you.
Oh, my God, really?
Wait, I haven't finished my statement yet. Wait. I love you as an actor.
Oh, thank you very much.
But I think I love you even more as a director, my friend.
Oh, man. That's amazing to hear because I'm liking directing. So.
Yeah, how is that transition? How has it been for you, my friend?
It's been fun. I've been acting since I'm 7, you know, so I guess I was getting tired of acting, and I started to feel the urge of telling my own stories. And when you try to do that from the position of an actor, you're a pain in the ass, you know?
Right.
Because actors should be there to serve someone else's point of view, to be the tool for someone else.
Right.
And I one day decided to go and start my own films, and I started producing first. To find a way into that, all of that process that actors are not invited to, you know, that is fascinating. And I started producing 10 years ago, and then I did a documentary. Then I did a film with actors in Mexico, a smaller film than this one. And then I did this one that is a very different story, huge in terms of not just budget, but it's period, you know, it's tons of extras.
Right.
There's violence, there is an amazing cast that
yes.
It's a lot of responsibility.
Let's talk about the cast a little bit, man. How did everyone fall into place? Who was the first one to sign on to the film?
I have to say that this is the first film I do as a director and producer that actors actually call to ask for auditions, you know.
Wow.
Everyone from this community understands how important it is to have films that can represent the Latino experience with all its complexity and its diversity and richness, you know.
Right.
We all struggle trying to get roles here that don't fall into the stereotype and that are interesting to do.
Right.
So when everyone heard there's a film about Cesar Chavez, I think we all had the feeling that there was hope, you know.
Mm.
If on the 28th of March people goes and fills the cinemas and they go and buy a ticket, they'll be sending a message that needs to be sent, that we want to be represented and celebrated in film, you know.
For sure, man. And how important is, you know, not only for Latinos to see this film, but young Latins, how important is it for them to know their history and to know where they come from? Because I come from field workers.
Yeah.
My great grandparents were field workers. And it's like now I'm here, you know, interviewing you about this amazing film.
Exactly, because this struggle and this fight needed to happen, and this community was around for us to be here today.
Right.
You know, this is part of where we come from. This is part of our history, and we have to know it. And not just Latino kids in this country, but every young person in America should know this happened, you know, because it's a very universal story about change being in our hands, you know,
right.
And change generated by people connecting to other people. And today this world needs change, no matter which community you belong to.
For sure.
And it's a message about unity and about equality, and I think a powerful one today. So yeah, hopefully this is a film that people get to share in family, you know, because this is a film to bring your parents or for your parents to take you, you know, right, and start a debate on where our food comes from, what needs to happen for our food to get in front of us.
Right. Well, brother, great job.
Thank you very much.
Great job, man. Great job. Nice to-